if you've ever wanted to place something in InDesign on a master page above the stuff on your pages, I'm going to show you how to do it. So I've got a document created. Over in my pages dropdown, I have three pages, and you've got the master page on top of that. Most master page elements end up showing up below the page elements. For instance, if I want the word location to be on every page, I'm going to go to my master, create a text box, and we'll type out that word. So we'll type out location, give it a font here. I'll try to do this really quick for you guys, and we'll scale this guy up quite large. So we got this big old word, location, written on here. Now this word is going to show up on every page. So if I double click back on my first page, and let's say I want to create an element underneath the word location that represents each location, like a different color box. Well, I'm going to create a rectangle, and we'll create this shape out here, and we'll give it a fill color of, how about like a very light yellow, something that black would look good on. Okay, well, it created it on top of the word location. Well, I don't want that. I want it underneath. But location's on a master page. So how do I do that? Okay, let's go back to our master page. We'll go back to pages, double-click the master page. Here's location. What I need to do is actually place this on an uppermost layer. So InDesign comes with a layer panel as well. Almost never really think about it, but there are times when you use it, and this is one of the best times to use it. So in the layers panel, notice if I drop this down, I have location in there on layer one. Well, I need to create a new layer, and we'll name this layer by double clicking the layer name. We'll call it master page, and we'll call it top layer. Okay, so this is for elements that I want to show above my pages on my master page. All other elements on the master page not in this layer will show below, just like normal. I'm going to grab this location that we created and drag it up to that master page top layer. Now it's on the top layer here. So now I can go back to pages, go back to my first page, and check that out. That object is now below the master page element, the master page header. And that's because this shape is actually on layer one. We just only see what's in the layers per page. So for instance, we didn't see this rectangle when we were in the master page layer set, but we will see it if we're in the page level layer set. So I can take this rectangle, copy it with Command or Control C, come down to my next page, and then the ultimate shortcut key, Shift Option Command V, or Shift Alt Control V, paste in place. That same box there, and I can change the color if I want to. Obviously, this is just sort of an arbitrary, design here, but you guys will encounter things at times that for sure, 100%, will need you to put master page elements underneath elements on the pages, as well as on top of elements on the pages. So this is how you do that. All you need to do is create its own layer on top of the layers that all of the page elements go on. I hope that you learned something in this tutorial. If you did, hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe for more tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.